In EDESIA, we're particularly interested in training a new generation of people interested in nutrition, but particularly nutrition from plant-rich or plant-based foods.
EDESIA was the Roman goddess of food and the feast, and she really emphasised the good things that we get from food.
In EDESIA, we're looking at how diet can impact lots and lots of chronic diseases, type 2 diabetes and cancer, of course.
With research really spanning across the way from crop to clinic. Partner institutes are the University of East Anglia, the John Innes Centre, the Quadram Institute, and the Earlham Institute, all of which are geographically quite close together. That expertise across plants, food, and health in all of those institutes gives the programme its multidisciplinarity. So it's a rotation PhD scheme, so that means that students do 3 research rotations in their first year across the partner institutes.
So it's quite good to pick a mixture across all the different institutes to properly like broaden your skills and also form collaborations and relationships with different groups.
Also, if you come from a more theoretical background like myself, you can very much get the skills, the wet lab skills, for example, or bioinformatics skills from this program, because the rotations very much allow you to learn everything from scratch.
You want to try 3 different rotations, ideally just doing completely different things from what you've done before. Then you might discover a new passion or a new research direction you want to go in, or you might even marry something new that you find with what you've done previously.
It allows you to find a project that really suits you and one that you're going to enjoy to carry out your main PhD on.
So after the rotations, you then can pick which lab group you want to do your full PhD project in. My project is looking at how the gut microbiota affects cancer, distant sites other than the gut. So I'm looking at currently in vivo models of breast cancer and melanoma.
As far as the EDESIA students go, we kind of vary along some work more on the plant biology side, some more on the human biology side, and I'm quite far down the plant end. So I work on legumes and pea in particular, and I'm really interested in the developmental biology of their fruit growth with a view towards improving their nutritional quality.
My PhD program essentially looks at the health benefits of the colored potatoes, which are rich in anthocyanins, the underlying mechanisms that could elicit health benefits are still not fully elucidated. My project is interdisciplinary, which bridges the gaps between the different expertise across the Norwich Research Park. It includes plant biochemists, gut microbiota expert, and the Norwich Medical School. We are working close to elucidate the implications of polyphenol-enriched food involved in healthy aging. This project really allows me to spread my wings across the Norwich Research Park.
For my PhD project, I'm looking at a metabolite called L-carnitin, which is present in red meat, for example. We know that if it accumulates, or if you have a lot of it, it's actually associated to a lot of chronic diseases, like cardiovascular disease, but we don't know the mechanism exactly. So we take these compounds and we look at them in vitro. So we use this colon model for that to see what the gut microbiota do, and also if we can inhibit the formation of this compound, TMA, by using polyphenol-rich foods. And one of those is the bronze tomato.
And I'm working on how dietary compounds, such as polyphenols, can be used to help combat pancreatic cancer, so pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma, and looking at how those dietary compounds and the gut microbiota can be utilized to help reduce the effects of pancreatic cancer.
So the resources here are pretty amazing. In Quadram, I know they have all kinds of quite sophisticated models of digestion that you just can't find anywhere else.
I enjoyed the academic environment here, which is really inspiring and stimulating.
So I think the expertise of the different research groups here makes it the perfect place for the EDESIA program to be kind of based.
What I have enjoyed so far, all the experience are really positive thanks to the support from supervisors and the cohorts, and of course, administration teams who are working behind the scenes, literally.
The EDESIA program is really collaborative. So just hearing other people in the year belows and in my cohorts, experiences and rotations and full PhDs, you get to see what they're doing in labs. You can form connections with them, and not only do we talk about lab stuff, but we also do lots of social activities.
EDESIA rotation PhD program is well supported, that is funded by the Wellcome Trust.
At the end of that, when you've done the PhD, then you get 9 months for what we call career development, and that can be anything that you choose to do. So you can go off and join industry, try that out for a bit, or go and do voluntary work somewhere, or whatever you want to do, so that you can use the knowledge that you've gained during your PhD, and it's an absolutely unique opportunity to do that.
Perhaps what I want to do after the EDESIA program is to also move on to the practitioner or policy side and see how those work.
It's a really valuable kind of career transition opportunity.
So I think the program really is for anyone with an interest in nutrition widely, in plants, food and health, but somebody who's interested in the detail of why it is that increasing plant foods in the diet leads to good health. So not just someone who wants to work in plant biology, not just someone who wants to work in human health, but someone who's interested in bridging really that gap.
So I guess it's the best opportunity for those who want to learn something new or are just really excited about integrating those three topics of plants, food and health.